Okay, so what I did was I went to the internet and I pulled some lyrics from a song. So I don't know if any of you know Brad Paisley, but this used to be my son's favorite song. It was "If I Could Write a Letter to Me." And he used to sing that all the time. So I thought, I'm going to do a layout that has the lyrics to the song. I could put it in the background. I can put it really, really light. I can change the color like Linda just did with her text. And you can pretty much do anything you want to as far as creating the whole background with this text. So what I did was I went to the internet, of course, and let me go to Google. And you could do this with Happy Birthday. You could do this with any song that your grandson, granddaughter, son is really into at the moment. So let's just go to Google and I'm going to type in lyrics to Letter to Me, I think is what it's called, by Brad Paisley. I don't know if that's how you spell his last name, but we will see. Okay, cool. What you can do is just go ahead and copy it. So I'm just going to take that. And it doesn't have everything there, but that's okay. If you wanted to get everything, you can probably click on here and get everything. But I'm just going to go Control C, and I'm going to go back to Photoshop. And I'm just going to go with File, New, Blank File. And in this case, I went ahead with an 8x8, and I kept it a little bit lower resolution just so I can see the whole piece on there. When you add text and stuff, you won't be able to. The text gets a little bit blurry, so I'm just going to keep it kind of at a low res. And then I'm going to take my text tool and I'm going to click and drag a big text box. And then I'm just going to go Control V as in Victor. Now I bet you I have it in white, which is totally fine. I'm going to close this one out. I bet my text is in white. So just let's go ahead and look. I'm going to get my text tool. I'm going to select inside of that layer. Go ahead with my layer over here. Make sure I'm on the correct layer. I have to move some of these little pop-up boxes around. So I'm in there and I'm just going to select all. So that's Control A on my keyboard, Control A or Command A on the Macintosh. That selects all of my white text. And then I'm going to go down to the wall color down here. And I'm just going to go with a black for now. Now, obviously this font is way too big and it's overlapping. So I need to go down to my scrubby sliders. I love that. I'm scrubby sliding to the left and then to the right. I'm using what Karen just retaught me again, which I totally forgot about. And then I'm going to scrubby slide this leading. It's so much easier. Thanks, Karen, for that. I'm going to go ahead. Let me see if I'm going to unmute Karen and Linda. But if you guys need me to mute you back or to turn you guys back off, is that okay to unmute you so you guys can talk? Because I feel like I'm by myself.
Oh, no.
I muted you guys because I thought, well, maybe if their dog barks then they won't be so nervous and stuff. But I can always mute you if you have something crazy going on in the background, girls.
I'm good. I'm fine.
Okay, I'm just going to kind of place it right about. Let's do a little bit more leading. I'm going to pull it right about there, and I'm going to left align it. And then I'm just going to go ahead and pull it in. Now, a lot of times what I'll do is I'll make it really, really light. So I'll go over to my opacity and I'll use my scrubbies. I'm going to be using these scrubbies all the time now. And I'm going to push that opacity over to the left and have it really, really light. And you can have, your pictures go over the top of it or whatever you want to do. Now here's another thought too, not just having it to the left-hand side, but I'm going to open up a couple of the other ideas just so you can see. I have it where it goes, fills the entire background and it also bleeds off of the sides. So maybe it's their birthday party. You can put happy birthday in the background. Another thought would be is to add a colored background to it. So you can fill the background with, let's just say, a solid color. And probably all of you know how to do that, but let me just do that really quickly with this one. If you wanted to fill this with a different color other than white, right now the background is white, you can go over to, let me just pull this and pull it out of the way. You can go over to your paint bucket and then pull in a different color. So right now we have black as our foreground color. Maybe we want something a little bit plum colored, so I'm going to pull this plum color up. You can go ahead in here, use the sliders, of course, to get a different shade, but I'm just going to go ahead and stick with this plum color and then fill it with that background. Then this is really, really hard on the eyes, so maybe you go back up to the text on that layer on top. Go ahead and select all. I'm just going to click one time inside of there and do Control A and then change it to maybe a light gray or something. And remember, you can always take the opacity down to lighten it up a little bit so it's not so stark. So that's another idea for maybe doing some lyrics in the background. What I did was then create a whole entire layout. So let's just bring that one up. We could rotate the text in the background as well. I pulled some of Karen's kit in here. It is, oh my goodness, help me, Karen, Springling. I knew Ling was in there. Springling. So I love that new kit. And this had some little music notes in there, so I thought it worked out really well for that. And also this little butterfly had some music notes. I just pulled Brad Paisley's picture off of the internet. And I know that some people are like, oh, that's copyrighted or whatever. But if you're not going to sell it and you're only using it for your own personal use, I'm okay with it. Are you ladies okay with it?
I am.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's not like he's going to come and sue me or anything. But I think it would be kind of cool for my son, you know, 25, 30 years from now. You know what? We were all lovers of Sean Cassidy. I don't know. Sean Cassidy was my woohoo. Do you remember Sean Cassidy, ladies?
Oh, yeah, I do.
So I think it's just kind of cool to have some of those things to remember.
So if you are wanting to watch this entire video, you can go inside of the membership area and just scroll down to 2017 Online Summit right here. Click on that, and this class was called Our Favorite Tips, Tools, and Techniques. And if you scroll over, like see how you scroll over, you can see kind of, let me turn this down here. You can see where that segment is. It's more towards the end. And it's right about, see this right here, how the little pop-ups are coming up? So it's right, starting right at about 110, mile marker 110-ish, if you wanted to see that. But there's all kinds of really cool tips, tools, and techniques from Linda, myself, and Karen. So go check out that whole entire class. If you're not a member, you can find out more information. We are going to be opening up membership here in a few weeks. So let me know if you want to get on that mailing list. I believe you can go to naods.com and get on that mailing list by going to tour. Actually, you're probably on that site now, and then just filling out this information, and then we will send you when our membership enrollment opens up again. Thanks for joining me, and have a great day. Bye for now.